I'll just explain a couple of things that I've done. One, I've attached the neck and I've turned this right side up. The silky side is currently up. I've turned it over, I've pressed it into place, and then I've actually top stitched this so that it sits better. Now secondly, I've cut the red satin on a bias and I've folded it in half and just pressed it into place. This is a proper silk, ribbon type of silk that actually you can, it's got a beauty of pressing into place. So it presses into place really, really nicely. And what I will do with this is I will attach this and then turn it over and seam this on the outer side. And because this is cut on a bias, it will fold to the bend of the neckline that's currently like a V shape. So that's the piece that I've cut for my neckline, which I'm going to trim off the side of this. I will need to change the thread to red, but before I go on to finishing that off, I'm going to just show you the putty that I've prepared for the hemline, which is this. This was the red, the green, and the strip lace that I've put together. Now, basically what I did was I cut all the pieces, a 6-inch piece, a 2-inch piece, and then we've got the lace insert of an inch. It's a very simple, straightforward stitching that's actually unselvaged on the wrong underside of the lace. I put the red underneath and stitched over the lace, attaching the lace and the red together, and then put the green underneath and attached that together. Then I folded it in half and I pressed the whole of the putty into place, which is actually this pressing that actually brings out the shine and makes it look really, really classy and sophisticated. Now that basically is the hemline putty that I'm going to be using on the sleeves and also on the hemline. So before I go on to these, all the pieces I attached together, what this has is, it has just over here, it has the central, you know, the lines where I had to join the pieces together. They're not very noticeable. Once you've got them attached together, you're not really able to tell where the pieces are. Unless you cut this across the grain, you will have to have pieces in your underpiece, under the hemline. So that basically is the finished hemline piece. I've done all the preparations. Before I go on to attaching that to this, what I need to do is I need to lay my dress and I need to trim it. It's a little bit too lengthy and it also needs to be rounded off. So before finishing this off, what I'm going to do is lay this absolutely evenly by folding this into the pieces, and I'm going to lay the back of the dress on top of this, and then I'm going to trim it down because it's just a little bit too lengthy with the hem thing going on at the bottom of this. It's going to make it way too lengthy. So obviously we want to keep the length but not to the level of the hem really. So what I will do is I will fold these absolutely evenly, and placing these on top of each other, making sure that all my pieces are sort of aligned, I'm going to trim sort of about 4 inches off this. One, this will even all my dress off, and secondly, it's going to shorten it up slightly so that it's not too long. Also, there are overhanging threads, and by cutting into this, what will happen is all the layers will be laid out evenly. So just make sure that all your pieces are absolutely laid straight. I think I'm a little bit distanced, just move the camera out a little bit so you can see what I've done. I've just layered it absolutely evenly, and basically I'm going to mark it out at the length that I require it to shorten it to. Preferably pin that into place so that it doesn't move out of place when you're actually cutting into this before you do cut into it. So with the chalk, decide on how far you want to go in. There was a little bit of a mistake that I made. I should have actually taken more off from the top so that I got more of the green left in this, but never mind. So measure your required length all the way in, just going, I'm actually taking 6 inches off this. If you're not sure, then you know, go less, and you can always go back to it. But actually, once you've laid it out, decide on your so what we have now is the dress has been actually shortened quite a bit, and what we're going to do is we're going to attach the hem piece. Now we've got to decide on how we're going to attach this. There are a couple of ways that we can do this. I can do the seam where it's actually just decide to do an invisible seam, although with this much fabric it may be difficult to actually do the hemline. I'm going to try this on the one, and if it works out, I'll show you how it is that I'm doing this. I'm not absolutely sure whether it's going to work because of the amount of the gear on this frock is quite a lot. Sometimes it's quite difficult to do that much width on the inside. But I'll try it out. I'll try it on the back of the dress. Yeah, this is the back piece. If you're trying anything out, always trial it on the back one rather than the front. So if you do end up messing up, then at least it's not that noticeable.